Tina? Listen, I don't think it's a good idea for me to take CJ to the movies tonight. Tell you what, how about if the three of us just have a quick dinner, all right? Then we'll put him to bed early, and then you're not going to have that talk we've been meaning to have.
Cora, darling, Tina's not here.
Renee, Ace, what are you doing here on a night like this?
Of course we came to get you to take you to supper.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I'm going to have to take a pass on supper. If you heard me yelling up to Tina, there's something we need to discuss. When did she say she'd be back? Oh, wait, don't tell me. She went out Christmas shopping, right? Even in this weather, she's going to take care of that list of hers.
Cord, she didn't go shopping.
I'm sorry, darling. Tina's made a decision to move out of the house.
Well, this is really difficult. I mean, there's so many colors to choose from.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, I want my little boy's room to be bright and cheerful when he moves in, so I think blue would be nice. No, not a pale blue. I don't think CJ would like that. You know, like a royal blue. Something for my little prince.
Something like that?
Yeah. Yeah, actually, that'd be perfect. With some white trim, I think that would be great. He would just love it, I'm sure. As much as his old room and his old house with the old toys. Big garden.
Miss Roberts, are you okay?
I'm fine, excuse me. You know, there's just so many things to decide before I move in. Can we take a look at my room and pick a color for there?
And for a lady planning to move into a new home, you sure don't seem too happy about it.
No. And the rhyme is too easy, man. Well, I mean, we're not into Moon June. We need something different, unusual.
Okay, man, be my guest. You write it down. I've been working on this thing.
Kerry. What's wrong? Hello?
Hi, Andy.
Hi.
You have a table for two.
You can sit anywhere you'd like.
Thank you.
Somebody's waiting for somebody. That is not you, money.
Well, it's not you either, is it?
What are you doing? Relax. Be cool.
Oh, man. This is time for being cool. This is not it. Hey, Rika, what's happening?
Hi. Oh, hi, Dale.
I hope I didn't keep you waiting, Rika.
Oh, no. Some things are worth it.
Why so surprised, sweetheart? It must have occurred to you that Carla Hesser would have had a duplicate. It certainly occurred to me.
Max, I can't believe you broke into the man's room and stole his personal property.
Well, you know, it's amazing what love can do. Wasn't it love that made you destroy the first copy of this tape? Anyway, now that I finally have it, I may be able to see what has upset you so much.
I already told you. That tape belonged to a horrible man, Carla Hesser, and I didn't want to have him.
Oh, look, sweetheart, I know what you already told me. But I need to see with my own eyes. So please. Sit down and watch it with me. Okay?
Here's what to do when you don't find the rainbows in this time. Here's where you go when it looks like the rain won't end. Don't cry.
You want to tell me something?
Yes. Yes, I do. I really think you're making much too much out of this.
Too much of what?
This tape. Carlo Hesser's private video library of all his properties. Well, it really is tedious, isn't it? I mean, we don't know how he got his hands on all of his properties. We really don't want to know, do we? I think we should just throw the tape away and forget about it.
That was good. Nice try.
All right, if you're going to bore yourself to tears, I'm not going to stand
it. Sit down. You heard me. Sit. What? Sit. There you go. It looks like it was shot from across the street. But why? Please turn it back on.
No, I don't wish to see any more of this, and I really don't know why you're making us watch any more of it.
Any more what? You think Carlo Hester is going after the bar? I mean, kind of small potatoes, don't you think?
I really don't know. It's just a stupid tape, isn't it?
You know, I hate not being able to trust my own wife.
Well, then, trust me, and let's get rid of this tape.
I'm sorry, I can't do that. I gotta find out what's going on between you and Tony.
Nothing.
He says otherwise. He's asked you to please tell me the truth. So please, sweetheart, tell me the truth. Why is it the Padre is practically begging me to keep you away from him?
I have no idea. The man is deeply troubled.
Are you part of his troubles?
No.
So you're saying there's no connection between you, Tony, and this tape?
No, there's no connection between us.
Do I look like a fool? Do I?
No.
Carlo Hester has this tape. You try to destroy it. Then when I finally see it, the first image I see is Tony? And you're telling me there's no connection?
I'm just saying that you can't trust anything to do with Carlo Hester. That's all I'm saying.
I don't give a damn about Carlo Hester. All I care about is you, my wife. And the least, the very least I expect from you is for you to tell me the truth.
I'm begging you. I'm begging you.
It's too late. I'm sorry. Obviously, you can't speak the truth.
Yes, I can.
The tape has the truth. So together, we're gonna sit and watch it, okay?
No. No, I can't do this.
Oh, no, you don't. Oh, no, you don't.
Let go!
No! Now, this time, you're not gonna run away from me or the truth.
Andy Harrison, Kerry Nichols, meet Dr. Dale Winston.
Nice to meet you both.
Hello, a doctor, huh? That's kind of nice. Are you guys eating? Would you like a menu?
No, I don't think we're gonna stay for dinner. We have a busy night ahead of us.
Oh, not another one of your surprises, Dale.
Well, you know me. I have to keep a few to keep things interesting.
Oh.
I can't wait to show you.
I would love to stay and listen to the rest of this conversation, but I gotta get back to work. Do you want some drinks or anything?
Sparkling water for me.
Yes, I'll have the same with a twist.
Okay. Anything for you, Kerry?
No, thanks. I'm fine.
All right.
You guys mind if I join you?
Oh, well, actually, I don't think we're gonna be staying too long.
Oh, yeah, so I heard. It's kind of a lousy night to be out on the town, isn't it? Unless you're a duck.
You're right. It is awfully wet out there, but fortunately, my car doesn't leak.
Oh, and it also doesn't run out of gas, which is more than I can say for some other cars.
Are you a friend of Rika's?
Yeah, you could say that.
Well, then I suppose you're used to it.
Used to what?
How beautiful she is.
Dale, please.
Now, don't be modest, Rika.
My friend looks like he's a little lonely, so I'm gonna go and cheer him up. You guys have fun.
We will, thanks. Congratulations, Romeo. You really took action that time, man.
Yeah, so what are you grinning about? I don't see your eyes looking at you either. Just him.
You're right. What is he, an undertaker?
Worse, a doctor.
A doctor? Gee whiz, man. You think the guy would be able to afford a nicer set of threads?
Yeah, well, she seems to think they're nice enough. Just face it, Miles. When it comes to the game of love, we're a pair of jokers.
Gordon, let's go to the library and have a drink before supper.
No, I don't want a drink.
I would like to understand what the hell is going on around here.
Like I said, honey, Tina has made up her mind to move.
Wait a minute. I thought there was supposed to be a time limit before she could even get into this apartment. I was planning on using that time to talk her out of this damn fool idea.
If you ask me, she's showing a rare bit of spunk.
Well, she couldn't have moved everything in there now.
No, not completely. The painters had finished and she could move a few things in. She wanted to get this done before you came because she knew you'd try and talk her out of it.
Well, you're damn right about that.
What is with you two?
Asa, please.
For once, she's doing the right thing.
Please, darling.
Hell, I'm the first one to criticize Tina. Now I'm giving her a compliment. For the first time in her life, Gord, she's not thinking of herself. She's thinking of you, CJ, new baby, and all of us.
Asa, come on, she's not thinking about a damn thing, especially CJ.
That is right, darling. Tina is really very upset right now, and she's also feeling very guilty.
And for damn good reason. Weren't for her, the Hesses wouldn't have hounded us, and Vicky'd be out of a wheelchair.
Asa, can you give it a rest for like 10 minutes, maybe? Huh?
Gord, I'm on your side. I'm on Tina's side now that she's moving. Hey, some marriages are made in heaven. So are divorces, like yours. Be grateful you found out in time before you got hitched.
Asa, do you have any idea what quit while you're ahead means?
Do you have any idea what the word hush means? I'm looking out for my grandson. Thank you very much. Cord, there's no sense waiting for Tina. CJ's got a sleepover at the Coopers. Oh. Grab your raincoat. We'll go to the new steakhouse by the lake. It's nice and dry, good food. Cordero, are you hearing me? Son is the best. You've got to accept that.
Tina's not moving out of here, not like this.
Cord!
Well, I went and checked out Tina's room. Half of her clothes are gone. Her jewelry kit, her makeup, shoes. Then I checked out CJ's room. Some of his stuff is missing, too. Some of his favorite toys.
Oh, Cord, darling, I am so sorry.
Sure seemed real quiet up there.
Look, I think I know why Tina's doing what she's doing. Look, I don't think she wants to hurt anyone. I think she wants to help. Look, with this baby coming, she doesn't want to be a burden to you or anybody else in the family. And in the light of everything that has happened, she feels that if she doesn't take this step, she can't make a life for herself.
What kind of life is she going to make for herself? All alone. A single mother taking care of a newly born child. Not to mention CJ.
Darling, a lot of women manage that against great odds.
Yes, I know that, all right? But Tina is not doing this out of necessity. She's doing it because she's running away.
Cord. Let her run.
No, Cord, listen to your heart, honey. If you feel this strongly about her moving out, you can't ignore it.
Sure he can. I get indigestion sometimes. I lie on the couch and take a nap, and it passes.
Asa, your metaphor lacks a certain compassion. If Cord feels this strongly about Tina, then he needs to go and talk to her.
That is the worst possible thing he could do.
Not if he still loves her. And I can assure you, I know for a fact that Tina is still crazy about him.
Crazy, I'll give you that. Yes, crazy like a fox. How do you know she's not using this moving out bit as another stunt?
Asa, the whole world is not necessarily as devious as you are.
Honey, look up the word devious in the dictionary, and you will see Tina's face staring at you. You got it? Cord, forget. She's bringing a Hesse baby into the world. Remember all the lies from day one. Hell, when is enough enough? Look, it's gonna hurt now, but then it'll pass. First start, a nice T-bone steak, yay thick. What do you say?
Asa, would you please stop talking about steak?
All right, look, both of you, I appreciate everything you're doing here. You've obviously given me both sides of this. But now it's pretty clear to me exactly what it is I need to do.
Thank the good Lord he's come to his senses. Come on, let's go eat.
I'll take a pass on it now, Asa.
Where are you going?
I'm going to find Tina. Tell her she can't do this.
No. Here, I insist.
Okay, well, next time it'll be my treat.
Well, we'll see. That's if there's a next time.
If you're trying to make me nervous, you're succeeding, Dale.
Look, there's nothing to worry about. I have everything planned. All you have to do is relax and enjoy.
All right, if you say so, Dr. Winston.
I say so. Let's go.
What? Leaving so soon?
Oh, yeah. We have a big night ahead.
Good night, Andy.
Good night. Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you, too, Andy.
Okay. Stay dry.
Did you hear that? Big night ahead?
So what, Miles?
Come on, Kerry. You tell me you don't mind. You don't want to know where he's going and what big surprise he has in store for
him? Hey, man, what do I care? We have a song to finish, remember?
Yeah, the song could wait. Huh? Well?
Well, what?
Are you coming or what?
Man, look, I think you should sit down. We should do... Man, I am a little curious.
Oh, just a little curious. Come on before we lose it.
Now stop the theatrics now.
God, what do you expect me to do? Stand there and let you insult me and accuse me of every crime in the book?
I'm not accusing you of anything, except maybe trying to stop me from seeing the tape.
Go ahead, watch the damn tape. I obviously can't stop you because you're so obsessed with the thing. Doesn't work if I run away. I only get soaking wet.
Well, at least we agree on something.
Well, I don't agree with your strong-arm tactics, Max. You got me so frightened and scared. I feel like I'm living with a stranger.
Yeah, I know the feeling.
There you go again. Max, what has happened to you? Why are you so suspicious and angry?
I'm not angry. Suspicious, yes, maybe. So what do you say? Are you ready to see the tape?
How long is this going to go on, then? Will everything that I say, every action I take, will it be, just turned around, twisted around? Am I going to live under house arrest for our entire married life?
You know, it's really interesting to me that you keep referring to crime and punishment. I don't recall putting you on trial.
Well, that's exactly what you're doing. Take my relationship with Tony.
All right, let's take it.
Yeah, all right, I admit it. Tony and I are very good friends. No, actually, we're more than that. Because, you see, we've been through a great deal together, and that has made a very special bond. You can understand how that could happen.
Okay, how special is this bond?
It was built on caring and kindness. And I wanted to repay that by helping him pay back his... what he owed to Outlook House, but you took my generosity and you just turned it into conspiracy.
Hey, wait a minute, please. I didn't go out and look for conspiracy. It found me.
Yeah, in your own imagination. And then every time I try to reassure you, you accuse me of lying, and I can't win any way I go. So I can't do this anymore. Max has got to stop. And now...
you're giving me an ultimatum.
You don't give me any choice. Because if you insist on playing that damn videotape, then it's obvious that you have lost any trust in me. And if that is the case, then what do we have here? What kind of marriage is this? I'll tell you what it is. We don't have a marriage. And is that what you want? You have pushed me to this. You know that I hate ultimatums. If you can't trust me, then we may as well call it quits.
Quits? End of our marriage, walking away?
If you don't have any faith in me, how could we possibly stay together?
Any faith in you?
Ah, you hadn't thought of that. You hadn't thought of the ramifications of your own actions. Well, glad I stood my ground then. Difficult as it is to stand up to one's husband, if it will keep us together.
I have no regrets. You see, I remember. You're using that same quote when you were using this particular approach. I don't really recall what lie you were using or trying to cover up at the time. But I remember your flooded tears. Accusing me of ruining our marriage because of my lack of faith.
I don't remember what incident you're referring to, and it's quite obvious that you don't either.
Okay. Let's put our faith of marriage to the test, shall we?
What test? What test?
What do you think? The tape. Carlo Hester did us a big favor, you know. He gave us the opportunity to see what our marriage means to us.
I know what my marriage means to me. I don't need a test.
Well, I'm sorry, but then I do. Now, let me be real clear on this. If there's nothing on this tape but real estate, as you claim it to be, and you have nothing to do with this tape, I give you my solemn word, I will never doubt you again.
Well, that will be too late. I need you to trust me now.
I'm sorry, I can't do that. You see, you gotta earn that kind of trust. And there's only one way to resolve this.
Not this way, please, anyway. Max, don't you love me anymore?
How can you say that? I love you with all that I am. That's why I'm putting us through this. I wish to God there was no doubt in my heart. I wish to God that there was no reason for me not to trust you. But then I look at you, and you're so frightened, so desperate, with your tears in your eyes. What do you think I'm supposed to do? Please make it easy.
Court forgets her last deadly deed and goes panty after her like a lovesick puppy.
That's an interesting way to think about your grandson.
The hell, I love that boy. I want what's best for him.
But darling, what about what he wants? Cord loves Tina, and not in the way you think, not with a kind of dreamy puppy kind of love, but with a real grown-up love that lasts no matter what.
Grown-up love requires two grown-ups. Cordero cannot do it by his lonesome.
Well, I don't know. I seem to manage all right.
And what does Sam Hill, does that mean?
I'm sorry, I couldn't help it. Let's drop the subject of Tina and Cord, all right? Besides, you were a lot more fun when you were thinking about T-bone steaks and a platter full of fried onions.
So I'm not grown up?
Well, sometimes. Sometimes you're, well, you're a little like Tom Sawyer, but then, you know what? I love both of you.
I'll be here first thing in the morning.
Great. All right. Thanks a lot, Jerry.
Good night, Miss Roberts.
Good night. Drive carefully in the rain.
I will.
Bye-bye. Well, it's gonna be nice. Not grand, but nice. It's amazing what a little color will do. And a rug. Yeah, I need a rug. It's gonna make everything just perfect. Must have forgotten his paint chips. If it's, Mr. Cord. Cord, if you're here to talk to me about this, look.
Tina, we need to talk, all right? We got some major problems. And we gotta face him head on.
Cord, I think you better put your raincoat back on, get in the car, and go home.
Why, Tina? So you can hide out in your little cave here? Face it the easy way?
Oh, you think this is easy for me?
Yeah, Tina, I think it is. I think it's real easy for you to run away. Instead of sticking it through, trying to work this thing out. No, that's the hard way, Tina. You know, that takes guts to do, and I thought you had the guts to do it.
Yeah, well, I guess you're wrong about me then, right?
No, I'm not wrong about you, Tina. Damn it, I know you better than anyone. Hell, I probably even know you better than yourself.
Cord, what is the matter with you? What's going on with you? You're supposed to be happy that I'm gone, that you're free, that you don't have to worry about me.
I never asked for freedom, Tina.
No, you didn't, but that's...
Just sit down, all right? Sit down. I want to talk to you.
Fine.
All right, first of all, I'm not going to take any whitewash here, all right? You understand that?
No, I mean, I don't know.
Tina, will you please be quiet and just let me say my piece? Now, look, I can't and I won't forget all of your lies.
I know, that's why I'm here.
I'm sorry, Gord.
Don't say you're sorry. Tina, did I ask you to say
no,
you're sorry?
No, I'm sorry. I didn't...
Fine. Will you just let me say this?
Yeah, okay.
Now, as far as Johnny D is concerned, we need to straighten something out there.
Okay.
At first, it was very difficult for me to deal with the fact that you let that man touch you, let alone that you let him make love to you.
Gord, I did it to save your life.
I know, Tina, I know, all right? It took me a long time to accept that, but I finally have, all right? I've accepted what that was.
You have?
Yes. I've talked to Max about it, and he's helped me work out some of the jealousy.
You're jealous? You're jealous? Gord, I told you that when he touched me, it
Tina,
made my skin...
Don't. You don't have to go through it again, all right? Listen, I know that if I hadn't been so hell-bent on getting in there, into Johnny's room, to get that damn remote, then you wouldn't have needed to distract him the way that you did.
Gord, I would do it again in a minute. I mean, no, you know what I... Wait.
I know. Tina, I know what you mean, all right? Can we get past Johnny D, all right?
Yeah.
Let the man be dead in his grave. Because we got bigger problems to deal with.
Yeah, the lies.
Yes. Like why you lied to me about ever having slept with Johnny in the first place. Why you continue to lie to me about carrying his child. I mean, I could go on here, Tina. The point is, all of that has been very difficult for me to deal with, and for the longest time, I didn't think I could deal with it. I thought that your lies had done so much damage to me that I could never recover. But then you know what?
What?
Something happened. I seem to let go of that anger, the frustration, the betrayal, the fear, the hurt, all of it. And there was something left.
What was left?
Love.
Love?
Yeah. I don't know why you continue to lie to me, Tina. I don't know why you lied to me about carrying Johnny's child. But there's not a lot I can do about that now. All I know is that when I went upstairs and I looked into your closet and I noticed that some of your things were missing, I realized how much I loved you. I realized that the love was more important than the anger and the hurt and the frustration. And that the love was enough to help me get over any problems we might have.
I don't know what to say, Cord. I mean, to think that we have a chance of getting back together again, but there's just one thing that you haven't mentioned. The baby. Is that what this is all leading up to? That you want me to choose between you and this baby? Thank you, sir.
Oh, if I bring you out on a night like this, I should at least try to keep you from getting pneumonia.
Yeah.
Your sister would never forgive me.
Oh, good old Sheila. I guess it's common knowledge by now that she's a little overprotective of me.
How she cares about you, you mean?
Okay, well, I'll be fair. It's a little bit of both.
Okay, let's not worry about Sheila. I just want you to try and concentrate on what's going on this evening.
Oh, boy.
Man, you must be seeing things.
Hey, man, I'm telling you, I saw him come in here.
A church? If Dr. Dell, this is Dr. Dell's idea of an exciting date, how much competition can he be?
Well, man, I'm telling you, you can laugh if you want to, but I'm going to check this out.
Be my guest, Sherlock.
You not coming with me?
Spending a night in a cold church is not my idea of an exciting night. I'd rather be back in Max's place pursuing the clientele.
So go, man, pursue the clientele, but I'm going to church.
Well, be blessed. Peace.
It's the whole neighborhood. Everything's out.
Oh, Johnny, I think that we should take it as a sign from the heavens that you're not meant to watch Carlo's silly tape. I'm joking, darling. A little light in the darkness.
Speaking of which, I think I better go upstairs and check on Al, see how he's doing. And, please, forget about taking the tape out and destroy it. Without the power, the machine won't produce the tape.
Max, hang on a minute. Al's fast asleep. He's been asleep since before you got home. The storm was raging then, so if he was awake, I'm certain we would have heard him. Come on, my darling. Can't we accept this blackout as a gift?
Be careful invoking the name of the Lord. Lightning may strike you down.
Well, I'm not afraid. God, or fate, or whatever it is, has given us this moment. A moment that we can be safe away from our storm.
Safe, huh?
Yes. We can be as safe and secure as we want. Here in the candlelight, there's no reason why we can't find our way back to one another.
I'm sorry, but you lost me.
We have so many problems. But there's one problem we've never had. Let go. Let go of everything except what I want to give you. What I can give you.
What game are you playing?
I'm not playing a game. This is something that we know how to do by heart. Max, let's do it. Right here, right now. I know you want to.
Must have went out the back way.
Nobody talks.
No, Tina, I would never dream of asking you to choose between me and your unborn child.
You wouldn't?
No. Tina, I know how you feel about this child. I know you love it, pure and simple. However this child was conceived, Tina, it is part of your life right now. It's got a life of its own. And this child deserves a loving mama and a loving daddy, too.
Cord, what are you saying? Johnny's dead. I don't know what...
Look, Tina, I'm saying I don't know how I'm going to feel about this child until I actually hold it in my arms. I mean, hopefully I'll be able to look down at its face and see your face. And hopefully that'll be enough for me to make me love it. Obviously, I'll never be able to love the child as much as you will. But I would like to try, Tina. And if we let this chance slip through our fingers, then Johnny D wins. I mean, is that what you want? You want the Johnny D's and the Carlo Hesters of this world to have everything their way? To win
no,
every time?
No, of course I don't.
All right.
Well...
So here's our chance, Tina, to beat them. Look, they got their guns, they got their hoods. We're just a couple of people who got caught up in that storm. But we can make a difference, Tina. Together, we can beat them. Together, we can't lose.
I don't know where this is going. What do you want from me?
You're almost irresistible, you know that?
And don't resist, give in.
Oh, it'd be easy. Real easy. Your eyes looking at me, your touch, your body next to mine.
It's chemistry.
Yeah.
And on a night like this, it would be perfect. We could make magic.
Yeah. Is there anything you won't do?
I'm just trying to show you how I feel about you and how I know you feel about me.
God said, let there be life.
Well,
so, as a good witch, is this a good omen or a bad omen?
Darling, let's turn off the lights. It's much better with candlelight.
Why? Are we suddenly afraid of the light? Or is it the juice that powers the VCR?
I don't give a damn about the tape. I only care about you and me. You wanted proof that you could trust me. You wanted evidence that you could trust my faith in you. All right, then. Make love to me now, right here, with the lights on or off. I don't care.
All right. You want us to be good?
Yes.
Okay. We'll be together. Even if it's for the last time.
How can you even love me?
Search me. But that's all I know. I mean, I get up in the morning, do my sit-ups, and I love Tina. That's all I know, Tina. From the minute that I first met you in El Paso, to the minute I thought I lost you in Argentina, to the minute you brought CJ into my life, to the minute I walked into your closet tonight, and I saw that you had taken those purple high-heel shoes off the shoe rack.
Thank God for my purple high-heeled shoes.
Some things are worth holding on to. Don't you think?
Yeah. Precious things.
Like what we have. Come on, Tina, we're still here. We're still together. And we're still in love.
Maybe it just means that nobody else wants us.
Could be. But speaking for myself, I don't want anybody else, Tina. So what, you still need me to spell it out for you?
If this is a bad dream, I mean, if this is a dream and I wake up, I'm gonna kill myself.
It's not a dream, Tina. Come, hey, look, I've made my choice. I've laid all my cards on the table, now it's your turn. I mean, I want to be your husband. I want to be the father of your children. All of your children. Will you marry me?
turn it off. Please, turn it off.
No. We're gonna watch all of it.
No.
And I mean all of it.
No. No.
Tonight, Larry and Balky try tanning at home on Perfect Strangers. Then, Jack needs some help to oppose a witch's curse.